Matt Waymire alongside Dan Rosen. It's 31 teams in 31 days with the addition of a new franchise in the NHL. But today, our focus squarely on the Carolina Hurricanes. 8 straight seasons without the playoffs for the Canes, the longest active drought in the NHL. Dan, they brought in a lot of big names in the offseason, and these guys have one common thread between them, quite simply, all former champions.
Yeah, they are all winners. I mean, you're talking about Justin Williams, who won his first of 3 Stanley Cup champions with Carolina in 2006. He's back on a 2-year contract. Look, he had 48 points last season with Washington. He can still perform. He's still a productive player, so they brought him back in. But the biggest addition is Scott Darling in goal. Now, they dipped into the Blackhawks well. They got Darling. They got Trevor Van Riemsdyk, and they got Marcus Kruger. But Darling is the most important one, obviously, because he's their new number one goaltender. Ideally, Cam Ward now is the number two, and Darling is the new number one. Eddie Lack is gone, traded to Calgary to be the backup there. So Scott Darling won 18 games last season with the Blackhawks and had a .238 goals against and a .924 save percentage. He's never been a number one. Has to be a number one there.
So it's easy to kind of fall in love with these new veteran additions on this Carolina team, but not to be overlooked is a very young core who had a good season this past year, but they need to take that next step.
Yeah, I'm looking at 3 guys in particular. You're talking about Sebastian Aho, Elias Lindholm, and Teuvo Teravainen, and by the way, another former Blackhawk. So you see the trend here. You see where they're going and why, and it makes a lot of sense how much Chicago has won. But certainly Aho had 49 points last season, Lindholm 45, and Teravainen had 42. Those 3 guys, they took the next step in their development. They were very good. I think they need to take that next step now for Carolina to break this trend of not making the playoffs, to finally improve and improve the offense too. They were 20th in goals last season with 212, and they were 21st on the power play at 17.7%. These guys, they were all 40-point scorers last year in the 40s. They should get to the 50s, if not one or two of them getting into the 60s.
I think the biggest leap that any hockey player can make, regardless of position, is that of a goaltender to go from the number two guy to the guy, the number one guy in net. So quite simply, biggest question, is that a leap that Scott Darling can handle?
Yeah, I think that's the biggest question, and it's one we don't know the answer to yet. But from what we have seen from Scott Darling and in his time with Chicago, it does make you believe that he can do that. And obviously, Carolina believes that he can do it too, because they not only acquired him, they signed him to a 4-year, $16.6 million contract. So they believe in Darling. His numbers suggest he should be able to make that jump, but we don't know it yet. He's never done it before, and it's going to be the biggest question for this team, and it's the most important thing for this team, because if they're going to get, like I said, if they're going to break this trend. We can talk about Aho, Teravainen, we can talk about those guys, Lindholm, but it's on Scott Darling to get them into the playoffs.
Now, the Canes made a very late surge in the regular season to get within striking distance of a wild card spot. They came up a little bit short. Does that drought end in 2018?
You're going to love me in Raleigh right now. Because, yes, right. I do believe the Carolina Hurricanes are a playoff team. I think Darling will make the jump. I think the younger players will step up. I like the addition of Justin Williams. I like Bill Peters as a coach. I think he's one of the best coaches in the league. This team is going to the playoffs.